How's it going, everyone? It's me, Noah, here, and today we're going to be taking a look at this package that I got from Culinary Customs. I'm very excited to open this one up, and as you can see here from the package, it's very, very bulky, very thick. And before I go ahead and open this, I want to give a huge thanks to Culinary Customs and Beyond the Brick. This is a special collaboration for some awesome creations that I'll be using these minifigures for. And if you're interested in seeing those mocks, you can find all of the links to those mocks down in the description below, for by the time this video is out, those mocks will already be ready and uploaded onto their YouTube channel. So huge thanks to them. Let's go ahead and open this package and see what's inside. First thing that I pull out of the package after opening it are a buttload of the Culinary Customs weapons, which you can find obviously on their website. I also talk about this in the videos that I show the mocks in. And these are just really cool. The standard weapons, obviously you can buy these separately, like I said. And that's the first thing that I went ahead and pulled out of the package. The next thing that I pulled out in these first minifigures that I'm very excited to look at, obviously, are these 327th and Commander Devis right here. These are some awesome looking minifigures, you know, just having the new cool P2, realistic P2 helmet design. Very excited to get into these. The red here from Commander Devis just really pops. And overall, these are going to be implemented in a scene that I've really been wanting to build for a while now. If you can guess which scene these are from, be sure to comment that down below before you go ahead and check out which scene I ended up using them in the links, or from one of the links that are down in the description. The next build that I have planned, or that I started planning, is going to be using these minifigures. These are the 212th minifigures, using, once again, the new realistic P2 helmet design. These are very exciting to look at, and I don't know what it is with 212th and the 501st. Those are just two awesome legions. Obviously, the 501st being my favorite, but the 212th coming in at a close second, just with this awesome orange. And again, the new helmet design is just so good on these. And speaking of the 501st, I'm gonna be putting these aside and looking at the last four minifigures. Here are the 501st minifigures right here. Obviously, you're only seeing three, and that is because I've went ahead and taken one out of the package. That way you can go ahead and take a look here at this design. Now, with the P2 helmet, like I said, this is a new one that they came out with some time ago, and just the design on this is stunning. I really think they did a good job. Obviously, there's been a lot of search for a good P2 helmet that's not decaled, it is printed, and that is more accurate, obviously, to those in the films. And this just does really well. And you know, you don't need to go ahead and pay like 40 or 50 bucks from other companies to get a good realistic P2 clone trooper, and it isn't decaled, it's actually printed. And Culinary Customs did an excellent job on this. So I think, if anything, looking at this now, I mean, from the pictures, I was very excited about this, but looking at this in person, it is just a very good design. And then overall, with the rest of the minifigure, putting the helmet here on the body, it really works well. And I'm very excited to use these minifigures in the mocks, or use them already in the mocks, which again, you can find all of those links down in the description below. That basically wraps up this video, everyone. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this, please leave a like on this video, comment down below your thoughts on these figures, and go ahead and check out the videos that I made on these mocks, implementing these minifigures in those mocks. And thank you very much to Beyond the Brick, as well as Culinary Customs, for giving me the opportunity to collaborate with you guys and do something with these awesome minifigures. Also, if you're already seeing those videos, or if you've already seen those videos, be sure to comment down below which one was your favorite of all the mocks that I used these minifigures in. And with that being said, everyone, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next LEGO video.